It's known as a flamboyance. Yeah, so you are looking at a flamboyance of Flamingo right now. Very justifiable reason for calling them a very, very extravagant animal. They're an extremophile that lives in situations that a lot of other animals can't. Like volcanic regions or salt lakes where most animals are going to dehydrate themselves by drinking the water. The flamingos, they have a filtration system in their beak, and so they can filter the salt out and still drink the water and survive. Now,
it's a real one?
It's a real one. There's no baby in there. But it's just like a big yolk inside. If you, you crack that open, that's about 24 chicken eggs. Whoa. Or about 2,000 calories per egg. It's a pretty sassy aunt. Here's Isha. This is his girlfriend. Aww. So we got the romantic couple over here. Rhinos are my favorite because they're our largest animal, but also they're pretty much like 5,000 pound puppy dogs.
Yes.
Big horn. Good observation. So the girl has a big horn because she doesn't shave down her horn as much as her boyfriend. Boyfriend, he's got to make sure he gets all those other male rhinos out of the way. So he fights the other one. Where are you guys going? But I saw them from the bottom of the hill, so I was like, let's come up here and say hi. These are an African type of cattle. These are called Angoli cattle. And I know what he looks like. He's really small, so pretty easy to spot. I'll point him out to you when I see him.
Is he way over there?
Yeah, I think he's over there. All right. I can't see. It's about two of the 12 or so different types of zebras you have in the world.
They look
lovely, aren't they? You can interbreed the two different species, it doesn't really matter. You can even breed it with the horse if you wanted to. And second, zebra are not very nice. Kind of mean. So if you tried to ride one, they would throw you off and probably bite you.
But you can find videos and photos of them online. People have
ridden it. And they no, they were fine. Well, I assume they were fine. At least in that short instance. But I wouldn't exactly jump out of the truck right now and try and go ride. Anyone getting chilly? Anyone need a blanket at all? Everyone's okay. Everything's good up there. What do we got over here? We got some. Oh, you got the big male eland up ahead. His name's Hammer. He's like the manliest of all eland. It's great. He's like 2,000 pounds. They're about the size of a walnut, so. But they look good.
Lean in, so it looks like you're taking a chance.
She's like, let me pose for you.
Their eyes look like balls.
One of their eyeballs is about the same size as
their head. Yeah,
hey, hey, be nice.
Look at me.
She's so dusty. It's the soulless dead eyes. Yeah,
it did not freak me.
You're brave. You do not have ornithophobia.
just a few.
Yes,
if you ever get into an ostrich fight, by the way, here's your top tip. Don't stand in front of the bird. They cannot kick back.
What's up?
You got